It is Friday, September the 25th, of the Lord 2020. The Gospel today is taken from St. Luke, chapter 9, verse 18 to 22. Once, when Jesus was praying in solitude, and the disciples were with him, he asked them, "Who do the crowds say that I am?" They said in reply, "John the Baptist, others Elijah, still others one of the ancient prophets has arisen." Then he said to them, "But who do you say that I am?" Peter said in reply, "The Christ of God." He rebuked them and directed them not to tell this to anyone. He said, "The Son of Man must suffer greatly and be rejected by the elders, the chief priests and the scribes, and be killed, and on the third day be raised." The Gospel of the Lord. We are today in at the center of the Gospels of Matthew, Mark and Luke. The center of the Gospel is who Jesus is. Jesus had been ministering, preaching, healing, expelling demons, and now it's proper to ask the question. But in the Gospel of Luke, there's this particular point that Jesus was in prayer in solitude. The Gospel of Luke is a Gospel of prayer. In the most important moments of the life of Jesus, Jesus is in prayer to ask, to discern what was God's will. What does God want from him? So he has to discern. So in that moment in prayer, like you just see in the baptism of Jesus, now when he for the first time announces his death, at Gethsemane in prayer at the end. Remember, prayer is a dialogue between you and God. It's a dialogue where you listen to God's word and then you speak. But the most important part of prayer is listening. We are used to pray, and we pray that this is an action, an activity of man. We forget that prayer is more a passive way. It's to be before God, to listen to his word, to discern what is the will of God in this particular moment in your life. What does God want from you? Then is when he asks the question, "Who do the crowd say that I am? Who do people say that I am?" And the people had some ideas. No? One of the ideas is that it's John the Baptist at the end, the continuation. He was beheaded by Herod. That was the idea. And we heard yesterday that Herod said, "No, cannot be, because I beheaded John the Baptist." Others, Elijah, because in the tradition, in the Jewish tradition, the idea was that before the Messiah came, Elijah should come again to prepare the way of the Lord, or one of the ancient prophets. But Jesus is more than a prophet. Yes, Jesus is a prophet. He announces God's word, but Jesus is more than a prophet at the end. He's more than a prophet. And the one who says the right question, the right answer is Peter. "You are the Christ of God." Remember, the name is Jesus. The title is Christ. We put together Jesus Christ, but the name is Jesus, the Son of Mary. And the title is Christ. You can read Mark chapter 1, verse 1, when it says the beginning of the Gospel of Jesus, the Christ, the Son of God. These are the two titles, the Christ, the Son of God. So Jesus is the Christ of God. He's the anointed, the one, what the letter to the Hebrews said, God spoke to us in many ways, and now he has spoken through his only Son, through the word, that word that was given to us. He is the one. And Jesus admonishes his disciples not to tell anybody, because it was dangerous. The people had different ideas about the Messiah, how the Christ had to be. Some thought that the Messiah would be a warrior, somebody who will destroy the Romans, who will expel the Romans from Holy Land. Others thought that he was going to be a wise teacher. Others thought that he was a high priest. But nobody ever thought that the Messiah would be a suffering Messiah, a crucified one. That is the greatness of God that we read in the Canticle of the Philippians that we will read next Sunday, the second reading, Philippians chapter 2, verse 1 to 11. And he is a suffering Messiah. He's not a powerful Messiah, but but the humble Messiah, who will enter Jerusalem not in a horse but on a donkey. He is the one. He is going to be rejected, but he will rise on the third day. He is the one. And the question for you today, who is Jesus for you at the end? Really, not only with your lips, but with your life. Do people know that you are Christian, that you are Catholic? Do they know that you are a Christian, believer in Christ, by the way you speak, by the way you behave, by everything you do? That is Christianity at the end. And we are the continuation of the mission of Christ. You are Christ because you were anointed in baptism to live like Christ. Today is Friday. We remember the death of Jesus. So the invitation is live this day some kind of penance, some kind of remembering that Christ died for you, for your sins. Live every moment of this Friday in the presence of the Lord. If you can go to Mass. We have Mass 8 o'clock in English and 7 p.m. in Spanish. Go. And remember now our Bishop, Cardinal Di Nardo, has allowed us to use the church at 50% of its capacity. So he gave us the authority, the authorization, to accept 50% of the capacity of the church. Salio, please come this weekend. Come. May God bless you today and always.